Tuesday. Skyline, got the dog, got my Italian son Mattia. One of our last rides here together.
Actually, one more. Never see the last one. One more.
Yeah, because he's leaving for Tahoe. Of course, he's working on his bike. And you race, bro?
I race from the couch to the kitchen.
You race? You've got a number plate on, man.
Wow.
You must be a competitor. You're not just a casual rider, you're a racer.
Yeah, I don't have time to take it off, okay? In 2 weeks.
And he's got his flashy new company car over here. Look at this thing. His new bosses gave him a Tesla. Oh, the airplane doors. Oh, he's opening the doors from his remote control and showing off. Did they buy you the bike rack too?
They already had it.
Oh.
It's a really nice bike rack. It doesn't have a pin, so it could slide out.
Did they use it for their Rad Rover e-bikes? Those are the bikes of rich people, right? Who's the presents for? Is that Natalie's?
Natalie's birthday, dude.
Natalie's birthday. Or is that like a wedding present, engagement present?
Who knows?
Did you propose yet?
Huh? It's gonna be a while.
Okay. This is Misa's second trail ride. First one was 3 weeks ago when I ate shit. I'm not taking my GoPro today because we're just going up and down this fire road. Because, you know, when we were in Indy,
yeah.
And I came up to you and I said, yo, dude, I'm here to watch you qualify for the main.
Yeah.
I was almost going to say, if you make the main, we're going to do a show this week. I didn't want to say that and like jinx it or put pressure on
it. Yeah. Don't
but we're here.
Expectations too high. We're here.
We're here.
We're doing it.
Big main event guy.
Not much more I could ask for, Don.
No. Oh. Was it what was it like doing the parade lap?
What was gnarly is I didn't know we had a parade lap. Because I'd never been in the main before.
Yeah.
But that was pretty fun. I mean,
yeah. Did you send it or did you roll around and look at stuff?
I definitely did a couple whips for people in the crowd. But when I got to the whoop section, I definitely checked it out because it looked like somebody threw a couple bombs in there.
Yeah.
Trenches. There weren't even real whoops anymore. They were just, it was a straightaway with as many ruts as you could imagine.
Yeah.
Peg deep. I thought about just going around them, maybe take my 3 second time penalty and pull in at the end of them. But
you want to know what one of the most embarrassing moments in my life is? Parade lap for the first moto at Loretta Lynn's. I fell in the rut in front of the grandstands.
First year I ever went to Loretta's on 50, I came through the sand section and tucked the front so hard, and the bike cartwheeled.
On the parade lap?
On the parade lap.
Okay, I'm not alone.
So I feel your pain.
But you were a little kid, I was 30.
I'm sure I've crashed. I'm pretty sure I crashed a couple years ago on the parade lap too. Just laid it over, but still, you still feel like a clown.
Yeah. Cooper Webb told me he crashed on the siding lap at Minneapolis or something.
Yeah, did he?
Yeah. So I was like, hey, feel your pain, bro.
Yeah. Look at you in your summer outfit. It's hot out.
Yeah, I mean, I just...
So what is this? Matilde's muffin?
Yeah, Matilde's... Is that a cupcake or kind of like a muffin?
Muffin.
Yeah, muffin.
Cupcake has frosting.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Yeah?
So, yeah, Matilde made that this morning, so thought about you, so...
Your fat
you
neighbor?
Try it. it's not bad. I mean, you're not going to gain weight on that.
Oh. Pretty good. So if I pass your house on the way home, can I pick up a case?
Yeah, I got a lot for you.
Huh?
I got a lot.
Do they seriously ship you cases of Twisted Tea?
Well, every weekend, Dustin's like, gives me a few cases to take home.
How you take it home on the...
They've been sitting there, because I mean...
What do you put in your luggage?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah, my check bag.
I'm coming to get a case.
I got some.
Yeah. They have different flavors, right?
I got like the regular, the half and half. I had a few of the like the case words like peach, raspberry, like all the different ones.
Yeah.
I don't know if somebody might have drank those.
Somebody.
But yeah, they're good. I like them.
Yeah. Did you guys look up the Big Country song yet for your chick?
No.
Are you? He's never heard that song in a Big Country.
Caught up in the country.
Are you serious? You talking
about Caught Up in the Country?
No. His chick's nickname is Big Country.
That nickname?
Well, he named himself like, Big Sexy.
Yeah, I know. I was gonna
that's
say
been that. Well, the Big Sexy started like back in like 2019 with I think it was like Coop and Jacob Hayes. They started calling me, and then when I went to KTM, that was literally all they called me. My suspension name would literally say Big Sexy. So that is kind of stuck.
Where'd Big Country come from?
Well, she's from Alabama, and that's like Big Country.
So she talk like that?
Oh, bad.
Yeah.
When she's with her family, oh my god.
You can't understand her, huh?
Talking to her aunt is gnarly. Seriously.
Oh. Chase, wait up!
This is Wednesday and we're at Lake Elsinore, and Max's guys are in town to finalize production testing on their new intermediate hard terrain tire, and got McGrath out here testing it, and I got Pat Foster. We both rode the tire like a year ago. Jared's bike, Pat's bike, Jared and Pat. I like the tire changing mount. It's part of the truck. Hey farmer, that's cheating, man.
What is?
The hydraulic.
Oh. Thing. It's the only way.
Huh?
There should be three of these in here.
I thought this thing would be fat full of tires. I heard they have three different rears to test.
Really? It was as terrible as you thought. I never touched the bike. So that was a year that I had to run.
Farmer, why are you out here now using the manual?
Oh, it works better on the front out here, believe
it. Oh, really?
Yeah, this machine, Ty Davis created it, and it's phenomenal. It works so good. I mean, and it fits into a hitch on a truck.
Yeah.
Everybody should have one.
Hey, just pinched the tube right there, it looks like. There's more baby powder around Lake Elsinore right now than at Babies R Us.
Those. Oh, whose would those be?
He bought those off Amazon.
Yeah.
Yeah, he told me.
There's only one guy worthy of running those.
Yeah. Farmer Maxis has come a long way since the Michael Young, John Burr Honda days off.
Michael Young, yes. Yeah, you know, the desire to be one of the most respected has always been there.
Yeah.
And, you know, it's pulling guys in like Jeremy, mm-hmm. doing these kind of tests, constantly improving the tires. It's what we need. And it shows the level of commitment.
Yeah.
I'm proud to be part of it.
Yeah, you've been here since the beginning.
I think this is year 22.
Jesus.
So, yeah. Back when we had desert tires for supercrossers.
Yeah. Do you remember the test where one of the engineers said, "What is this?"
Yeah.
The rim lock?
Well, that can't be okay. Yeah. Were you there that day, really? Oh, that's funny.
With Michael.
Yeah, that was an eye-opener for a lot of us, you know?
Yeah.
And I believe it was a Dunlop rim lock, even, to rub aluminum or salt in the wound, but we've, of course, we knew what it was, you know, over here, but, it was a little bit of an eye-opener on how much we got to go, you know. It was a big learning curve.
What helmet today?
Oh, man.
This is the one you got at the 9-inch row, or the 10-inch row, isn't it?
Yeah. No. This is my second one.
Second
one? Yeah, that's my second one. See, it's got a little Gucci gold on there.
It's good.
It's cool.
GoPro mount, maybe we'll mount you up today.
Yeah, I got a GoPro mount ready for you.
So you rode this tire a year ago or something?
I rode this tire, honestly, I thought we'd have it out probably a year ago. I'm not sure what slowed it down on the manufacturing side of things, but.
Well, it was your knee.
It was not my knee.
You couldn't do the final approval test.
No, I don't think it was my knee, for sure.
But so you rode it. You've ridden this tire earlier on.
Yeah, I rode this tire early on. We did a test at Cahia, and it was awesome.
Yeah.
So, like, I felt like it was ready to go and ready to produce. But anyways, they must have, for whatever reason, decided to delay the intro. So here we are today, and we are going to do the final, testing on the tire, and probably just reconfirm what we already knew.
Yeah, he said he has three different constructions to test, so I guess probably different side walls or something.
Yeah, and we needed a hard pack, so that's why we're here at Nelson. So. Yeah.
Yeah, man, we do not want you to hurt yourself. Just let me get it.
Oh, dude, see, I even said and I'm up here, but he's about to fall for it.
Are you Frankie's kids? I could tell. What's your name?
Jackson.
What is it?
Jackson.
Jackson. What's your sister's name?
Avery.
Hi, Avery. Do you know your uncle? Homer? You don't have Uncle Homer? Yeah, you do. Does he still ride mountain bikes?
We don't know.
You don't know? Does Homer still ride mountain bikes?
Yeah.
He does?
Uncle Sean.
I said, you have Uncle Homer now.
No. Uncle Sean. That's who bought him the jersey. Your Uncle Sean did that.
I see you every day.
So you're still here.
Oh, I see you Saturdays. I see you
Tuesdays and now Wednesdays. Yeah. Do you have any muffins in the car?
They're all gone.
Damn.
Oh. What's new, Don?
Huh?
What's new? So you go ride with a puppy?
Yeah, that was very
exciting.
It's not
a puppy anymore, is it?
6 months.
Oh, it is.
Yeah. Yeah, and then some guy messages me and says, are you going to send your dog to rattlesnake training? I'm all, what?
Is there such a thing?
Yeah, and so then his wife's texting me, and you take your dog to this place, and they put a shock collar on your dog, and they have like rattlesnakes with no teeth, and the rattlesnakes, and you shock the dog so they know that the sound is bad, I guess. I don't know. But then my other friend says you can give your dog rattlesnake vaccination.
Oh.
So I don't know.
So if you already inject like the venom or something.
Yeah. Then you can. So that was a good muffin though. I want to talk more about the muffins.
Okay.
I've never had a pear and a muffin. It was delicious.
Really?
Yeah.
It was a gluten-free one actually.
Huh?
In case you're gluten free, yeah.
Yeah, I don't know if I'm allergic to gluten.
I am, so.
You are? What is gluten? If you have a gluten allergy, what? It makes you like itchy?
Well, you can either have an allergy or sensitivity. It's different.
So, which do you have?
Sensitivity.
And so, what does it do to you?
Makes
you feel glutinous?
No, just more with my skin.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. Like acne and stuff.
Oh.
Yeah.
Are you gluten sensitive, Marvin? No?
No.
No.
Not really.
Is there gluten in Cold Stone ice cream? I found that picture last time.
I know.
Yeah, it was probably the last time we went.
Really?
Actually.
I remember when
we used to go all
when you guys
the time
first
the
moved
year.
To Corona, you were like, oh, Cold Stone. So
no,
I got you a gift
card. I'm a pink berry fan.
Pink berry's good.
Yeah.
But Cold Stone.
Pomegranate. Yeah. Flavor, that's my go-to.
Right? But Cold Stone, the way they, you know, they mixed whatever you want and the ice cream, I never seen that before. It was,
yeah, but that's
it's
dangerous.
Nice, it is dangerous. Mattel used to go crazy, though.
I used to make
it
the big turbo mix.
The love it? The love it sauce?
I know, remember I put the cookie dough,
it was cake,
caramel.
Cake batter flavor.
Yeah, it was crazy.
Brownie and caramel and chocolate fudge. I mean, it was terrible.
You know what gets me is at Christmas time, they have a flavor called dark chocolate peppermint. It's so good.
Oh, you might like that.
I'm a mint chocolate chip person.
Yeah.
And I found that ice cream with a base of avocado. It's
amazing.
Oh,
yeah.
Oh, wow.
It's crazy.
It's healthy, and I just love it.
Okay.
So, you get
but
check
pink
it
berry is your jam now.
Yep, pink berry is my jam, but
they piss me off because they close at weird times.
They close at 8 p.m. Like, yeah. We barely have, like, dinner starting at 8 p.m.,
yeah.
So... Like if I want to go get a dessert, I'm screwed.
That's no good.
So I got my avocado ice cream.
Okay. So Marv, you're still here pounding the laps.
Yeah, I'm waiting.
I saw Cooper leaving already. Like,
I just waited for Cooper to leave so I can do another moto.
So you can really hammer down? Okay.
No, we actually did a moto like at the same time, so that was nice. So
you really want to know what we're waiting on right now?
Yeah, what are you waiting on?
We're waiting on the Stasic battery to recharge because the kid wants to go ride with mom on the little track over there. That's nice. Why we're waiting on. Well, what is he going to ride on the track with Jax?
Yeah, we'll ride it.
Okay, so I dropped my bike at Roy's and then I went and rode. So there's a new rule, new protocol. When you bring your bike and expect Mike to work on it while you're waiting, you gotta bring him a frappy. But if you leave it, you have to bring a Western bacon cheeseburger combo.
I have my gloves on, I cannot pet you.
Oh dude, double.
Frappy double Western.
Oh man.
I was explaining on the vlog that's a new protocol. That
Hey pup.
Oh, the hamburger's for your dog though, right?
You good dog?
Ellie's definitely gonna eat that.
Yeah.
Come on. Straw like a pro.
No.
Come on, do the straw.
No.
Oh, friends. You're like the same age? Or no, yours is older.
10 months?
No, oh, mine's 6.
She wants some food?
Oh, no, 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 no. Shit.
Oh, she likes her fraps too?
So for the first 7 years of my career at Cycle News, I covered flat track racing. Every flat track guy grooves his tires.
We don't want to give out our secrets.
Oh, you guys are doing different patterns.
A little bit of this, a little bit of that.
A little of this, a little of that. It smells like Pop-Tarts over here.
Come in here.
All right, so you watch the vlog.
Swap Moto Live. Dude, the best. Swap needs to keep riding. Dude, your mountain biking is getting so much better. You need to keep at it, brother. You are looking good.
Well, you
good.
Know I ate shit on my bicycle and broke my collarbone, right?
Yes, of course. Hey.
Everybody breaks
live fast, die young, baby.
Yeah.
Or at 50. Live faster, die at 50. It's
yeah,
okay.
I got nothing left to live for. I might as well send it, right?
Hey.
Huh?
What is that you say? You're not here for a long time.
Here
you're
for
here
a good
for a
time,
good time,
not
baby.
Long. Yeah. Exactly.
That's what we're here for.
So what else on Swap Moto Live is good?
Oh, just all of your content.
The episode with you and the King was awesome.
Oh, you like
the
that?
The King and I, Swap.
Dude,
it
it's
is
good,
so
right?
good.
Isn't it hard to believe me and McGrath are buddies again after all these times?
That's amazing.
Did you know he didn't talk to me for 10 years?
I didn't know
why.
Oh, we had a little misunderstanding. But yeah, no. Mm. Did you see the latest one where we went to his house?
Oh,
yes.
That and that hallway?
Yeah, unbelievable, right?
The fact that he has all of his helmets and all of his gear, like, that is the most amazing thing in the world. Like, mm-hmm. that he keeps that stuff?
Yeah.
So crazy.
Never gave a helmet away.
No.
How crazy is that? That's he has every helmet.
Man, dude, it's just wild.
Yeah.
72, Swap. Man. Nobody's gonna beat it.
Yeah.
72. No one.
Elo, I didn't see it. Was it gnarly? I heard the bike came flying off and took out JB. JB and JB.
JB and JB. Yeah, it did. From where I was, it didn't look that bad initially, but then I saw the video of it and it was pretty gnarly. Yeah.
So JB is probably at the hotel?
He's inside
he
actually,
he
just
okay.
chilling. Yeah.
So when your guy's out like that for the night, what do you do with the rest of the day? You just get a head start on your breakdown? Is that what you're doing right now?
Get a head start on the breakdown and hopefully get things ready for Seattle next week, but we'll just have to play it a day at a time.
Now, would you do a full rebuild like you normally would, considering you only got one practice session in?
No, not typically. You know, I'll switch out suspension and obviously check over the bike, but don't have to do a full rebuild with it only having 20 minutes on it.
Yeah.
So.
Who's a harder guy to work for, JB or old Presto?
JB.
Yeah?
JB is a little more particular on some things, and Travis just doesn't know any better and just...
He's just a desert rat, huh?
Exactly. He'll just, if the wheels are falling off of it, he just rides it, so...
Cool. So what do you think about your first first half of a season back on tour?
It's been fun. I mean, yeah, definitely been fun. Knowing it's just Supercross only is, you know, you can see the light at the end of the tunnel pretty soon, pretty quick. But it's been super fun to catch up with old friends like Frankie and everybody. Yeah. And I've always enjoyed, you know, wrenching. It just gets to a point in your life where family and weekends are too important. So. Yeah.
Okay, so with this being JB's farewell Supercross tour, were you like, okay, I'll come do that? Like, you're gonna go back to your old job? Or what are you gonna do after this? Are you hooked again?
After the season?
Yeah.
I mean, definitely wanted to come back because, you know, I had the opportunity to work for him as his final season, and then we may do some other stuff after this, World Supercross or whatnot, but just kind of left the door open. Don't really have anything set in stone for, you know, after he's done, but just kind of taking it a day at a time.
Yeah, cool. Well, enjoy your night off. Cool. Quote-unquote night off.
I wish I didn't have a night off, to be honest with you.
Give me a tour of your locker, do you? Of your space, my personal
locker,
space.
My locker space. Obviously, you know, you see where it says Malcolm. Honestly, I'm not gonna lie to you guys. I don't really know what half this stuff is in here, but obviously I have like, this is like the pants where we have all our gear and stuff. So Roger hooks it up. This is like all like, of course, CTI always hooks me up, so they always give me some extra knee braces parts and stuff. There's extra couple knee braces in here, so you know, you never know what you run into when it comes to stuff like that. And then this is where we keep like spare stuff, of course my trophy, because it's kind of hard to fly with a trophy. The home, another pair of knee braces, my two Shelly helmets. There's a charger, Roger charges his phone in. I didn't even know that was a plug-in in there. Just more gear. We always pack a little bit extra stuff just because we do, riders do press day and stuff. You never know, you know, you never know how much gear you'll run into. And of course, there's more heavy, you know, jackets. You see, I kept that. I actually, when I went to the Indy Museum, they gave me a jug of milk.
But it says do not drink.
No, don't drink it. Don't drink it. I don't know how long that's been sitting in there for. So, but yeah, pretty much that. And everything else is just more storage wise, you know. Just more hats, more jackets. And of course, usually we have typical boots and stuff in here. So.
What's your favorite color boot?
You know, favorite color boot. To be honest, I kind of like all the boot colors so far. Red stands out to me pretty good. I do like red a little bit. We wore it at A3 when we did the full red. I thought that was, honestly, I feel like the boots match when you got the kit and the boots, that's what makes the kit pretty cool. Last year, the kit, we had one in Dallas. It was like that lime green. It was like a lime green boot. I think it was black and green, and we had a kit that kind of matched it. I thought that was pretty cool, but majority of the time, I typically just run black and gray, and that's just the reason why we run black and gray. It's just being in Florida, being in Florida with that clay, it can kind of stain your boots, and it's a little bit more cleaner for me. But majority just. I like whatever's just thrown at me. I just get told what to do at this point. I don't have no sympathy around here. Everybody just tells me what to do, you know, including my dad and my mom.
So what about your travel kit? You travel on those slides?
Nah, these are race slides only, man. These Gucci's, man. See that tiger, boy? Nah, I don't even have a pair of track walk shoes. I use my, literally these busted old, those things are, they stink, all kinds of stuff too. But, I try to pack light as much as you can, because that's what's cool and beneficial about having a locker is you only thing that you really got to do is just really show up. And I'm thankful to have a full locker, because
in my past, I didn't really have much to work with. Even on the team I was with last year, I was in the back with wherever they had fuel and stuff like that. So when I finally got on the team and, you know, they gave me my own bunk, it's like some of the little stuff like that you actually appreciate. So just from where you come from, and, you know, not saying that I'm better than that, I'm just saying, like, it just feels nice to have your own little bunk in your room, and you're not having people like, oh, excuse me, oh, I got to come back here and pump fuel, and you smell fuel back there. It's just, or you're stuck down there in the lounge trying to take a nap or whatever. So it's just cool to have that stuff. I'm happy about that whole situation.
You got your Man Crush Monday bag.
It's your bag. What? Go ahead, Dino. Say something. Yeah, MCM, you know. I call it Man Crush Malcolm. That's what that's called. But yeah, that's pretty much the tour.
So wait, you got new braces here. The CTIs are new because you used to wear them funky ones from it.
Yeah. I'm on CTI's board. I've ran CTI when I was an amateur, and we kind of shadowed away and rode with a different company, and now it's always good to come back with these guys. And of course, I'm a massive Raider fan, and I love fishing, and they made me two different types of knee braces, and I like that they make me any color, and they ask me whatever I want. The cool part about it is they asked me the first time, you know, what do you like, and I said, you know me, I said, you know, I love fishing. So they made an actual fishing lure, you know, with the bass and stuff biting the lure, and I thought that was pretty creative. So I wanted to say thank you to that guy who designed that. So that was pretty cool. And of course, they know I'm a Raiders fan because, you know, follow me on Instagram and stuff. So I hope the Indy fans aren't too mad because, you know, I'm a Raiders fan in a Colt stadium. But sorry, guys. But hey, I stick with that. And man, it's cool. Just so far, all my sponsors have been with me for a very long time now, and we always try to get creative and do the simple things. But you know, even with those knee braces like that, of course, they to a fan, you know, of course, you guys just, you only see the pant part of the gear and whatever. But it's really cool for a rider to see little details like that. That's like, that's actually something I look forward to seeing. Like when they say, hey, we're gonna send you a little surprise kit, and I'm like, dude, these are, you know, Raiders, and I'm like, it's just cool to me, you know, to feel like special like that. So, but yeah, everything, Shoei's been really good, Scott has been great with me, of course, Garnet, they send me whatever boots I require. Most of the time, I always just ask for pretty much whatever, a standard boot, you know, as in black, white, you know, I'm never really too picky about the color, unless we're gonna do a photo shoot and stuff. But there, I always have a couple different sets of boots, so whenever we do those photo shoots or whatever, I'm kind of set. And same thing with Shoei and Scott and whatever. So gear wise I'm always set. And of course, GoPro's always hooked me up for whenever I'm doing a lot of fishing, or if I want to do some riding, or for putting on my chest or whatever. So they're always been fairly really really good with me, and working with those guys last year was cool, and of course working with those guys again this year is even more cool. So I got those guys, and then of course Abu Garcia, that's another sponsorship that I've been sticking with. From I started with them last year, and I'm with them again this year. So those guys have been really cool in the fishing world. If anybody knows who Malcolm Stewart is, you guys know I'm a fisherman big time. So I actually did some fishing this week. Did some fishing behind my pond. It's always good and just so you guys know, I bought my house, and the only reason I bought my house was because there was a pond back there. Other than that, I didn't really care about the house. I just wanted the house with a pond back there. It was a little out of my price range with the lake, so I had to kind of back down a little bit, you know, let me get a couple podiums, win a couple races, then I'll get the lake, you know, I'll move to the lake part. So we start with a pond, you know. But I did some fishing this week. I posted a little bit of stuff on my social media, and the crazy thing is, so this fishing story is, I've been and I probably shouldn't say this, but I'm gonna say it anyways to you guys. So I'm not really supposed to feed the fish, but in a community like that, but I'm doing it anyways because I want the fish to come to me. So when I walk outside, you know, I want to cast one time and bam, I want to catch my 4 or 5 pounder. So I baited these fish up. I've been putting fish food. I actually bought dog food. But you know, I gotta go a little cheaper way, you know. You know, fish food ain't cheap, so I went dog food. So just so you know, if you guys want to do that, just buy dog food. Whatever you want, kibbles and bits, IMs, whatever the work higher. So bought some dog food and I would get up in the morning, go do my spin workout, and go out there and grab 2 scoops of dog food, throw it out there. And I did that 2 months straight. Well, that's a cool thing when I was in off season. 2 months straight every day kept going. And then next thing you know, the fish will literally sit there and wait for me just to throw it. And as soon as it hits the water, it's just pow, pow, pow. And then you'll start seeing these shadows come up where the big boys come up and they'll just start getting. So once I got that set, I'm like, all right, cool. Well, the bum part about me was they got so used to me feeding them, and then the season started and I was out on the West Coast for a while. I felt like somebody else took my fish away. So I come back, I did the same thing. I only threw a half a scoop of food out, and I saw a little bit, so I was like, oh, they still love me. And one of the, like I said, I'm gonna go back to this story, because when I was baiting these fish up, I had a kid that, you know, probably high school, you know, a couple kids that come out. Well, one of his buddies was a couple houses down from me, and he was on the other side, and he comes walking, and he's fishing. And then he throws right behind where I was throwing all that fish food, boom, catches a 4-pounder, right? And the funny part was I'm sitting in my back patio, just kind of just watching this, like it's just a matter of time if he catch something big. Boom, he catch something. I walk out there, I was like, hey, they really biting on the other side. He goes, the kid snaps on me, he goes, no, they biting right here. And then he calls his buddy, he says, hey, they biting over here. Man, about 4 or 5 of them jokers come over there, tearing up my fish, man. I was just like, golly. So I wanted to go fish the next, so I went and fished the next day. Didn't catch nothing. Oh, he gave all them sore lips. The bass ain't biting nothing. I even threw some fish food out to see if they'll come up. The bass too smart. They said, nah, we good. So that was kind of the story, the highlight. And still to this day, I actually see, and it's for a pond, that the pond gets pressured a lot more than I expected. It is, I don't know why, but a lot of people fish back there, so, and they love specifically fishing my spot. So I'm trying to think of, I'm gonna go find me a new area where they don't know them, so I can go bait the fish over there. And the cool thing is, like, the pond splits up a little bit, so they can't really cast where it far enough. So I'm gonna go over there and I'm gonna start baiting them up. But I ain't gonna post it on my social media, because I don't want none of y'all to pull up on me either. So I'm gonna get y'all too. So I'm gonna get the big one, all right? I'm just waiting for a big hog. But other than that, that's pretty much what I do. I try to fish. Just about, I try to fish at least maybe 2-3 times a week, you know. Any days that we have off, of course. Our training schedule is pretty tough, but we try to go as much as we can. I'm over here about to get in trouble with my team manager.
You got 2 minutes before you're supposed to be down there.
Oh, all right. Well, it looks like, hey, we're going to have to wrap this up real quick. I got to go racing, guys. I'm sorry.